I was telling you about how that man gave them the people that land. It was 1,660 acres of the plantation, but he sold it for $1,600 to the lady named Sandy Cameron. But they could sell it. I'm not sure what it was. How many acres they was able to get? But it was going like for $12 an acre, $8 an acre, something like that. But I don't know how. But one of the deeds that my grandfather had, his was $1 an acre. I don't. And I think maybe the rest of them probably did the same thing. But can you imagine when they don't have nothing, any money, how long it took them to pay off that $1? Because they probably never did have any money. But they wasn't, my sister said they weren't allowed to sell any of that crop that they raised. They couldn't sell all that stuff. So that's all about the cannons. My grandmother had 16 kids.
Now you said somebody almost made it to 100 years old.
Oh, that's Miss Alice. They said she died in 2015. She died in 2015, I think. And she was almost 100 years old. Yeah, she died August of 2014. Shop 100th birthday. So her family was real prominent around there. Their name was the Hargis.
Now, it's a lot of grandchildren here, a whole lot of people here today. And I don't...
It's four generations.
Wow, four generations here today.
Myself, my daughter, my granddaughter, my grandkids, and their kids. So that's four generations, right?
Yeah.
Four generations. We have to start on the 50th, because they ain't too little. Well, I hope I'll be around to see you.
Now you got Bop Day 2021. Let everybody know what that's about.
Tracy could tell you better on how that got started. Because we always have picnics and stuff. The last one, he was here. And he said he enjoyed it and he wished it would happen all the time. And Tracy said, yeah, we're going to do it all the time. We didn't know that he was going to pass a few months later. And that's how it began. After he died, we just started having it every year. And every year, like today, it would rain. It didn't rain as hard, but it rained.
And I talked to his son and his nephew. And I talked to a lot of people today, but they was all saying that he always looked out for everybody. And he was real humble.
He looked out for people. Yeah, he was humble.
And so this is wonderful, you know, what's happening. And then to bring everybody together, you know, is just a beautiful thing. It's a lot of intelligent people here, a lot of gifted young people here. I got a chance to talk to a lot of them. It's just good for everybody to know family and stuff like that. What do you want to say to all the family members?
Well, I'm glad to be here. See everybody going except me. God chose me. I must be special. So I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to see how all of them is growing up and how good the progress is in life. And it's sure to have a lot of kids.
Your daughter, Tracy, is very special. I do photography. I work with a professional photographer, work in New York Fashion Week, Pro Football Hall of Fame, Youngstown State University, models, professional models. So I met her on the internet for her Michael Stevens Fashion Week and was able to take pictures of her fashion show. She's very humble, like her mom, I see. And really good people skills, like her mom, I see.
Yeah. I raised them to be like that. Tracy, she always been smart. They used to call her Einstein in school. But she always was smart. She always would try to do things. She always tried to make sure, you know, because people used to tell me I couldn't be perfect. So I had to tell her the same thing. You can't be perfect, you know. It's going to be a little something. But she always tried. And I always instilled in them, be good to each other, be good to people. That's important.
And now her sons, I'm really impressed with them. Very mannerable, very respectful, and I always like talking to both of her sons.
Yeah, they're good. They're good. Most of the kids in this family, the good kids. It's my grandkids. They're real special. They're good.
Well, I had a great time up here today in Akron, Ohio, and I'm glad I got a chance to talk to and meet some very wonderful people. I can't wait to get back to Youngstown so I can eat my food.
Well, it was a pleasure having you. It was nice to meet you. I enjoyed my time spent with you today.
Well, thank you very much.
I hope to see you again soon.
Amen.
Okay. No!
All of these balloons have like the people that's not here anymore.
We live, Tracy.
We had, you know, we had some people that they got to live their life and they passed on, which is a good thing. But we also had some fallen soldiers, like my little cousin, No Fear. We didn't get to meet him. He was murdered in October 2020. You know, our cousins, Ricky and Gino. Fly Lou, our cousin Wookie, my nephew Michael. So we have, you know, some people that we lost that got their life took because somebody else felt that they shouldn't be here. But then, you know, we celebrating the day because of Ronnie. We got here 1 year and we were under that tree and he made us promise to do this every year. Well, he made me. So he always talked me into some crazy stuff. But anyway, it was his last picnic, so that's how we got locked down. So we're gonna release these balloons. They got messages to, you know, the people that we love. And then, you know, when y'all release them to the sky, make a wish for peace and happiness for the people that we still got left.
Let go, Al. Let's see your granddaddy.